Gun tracking typically is easier said than done. So tonight, our 13 Investigates unit is breaking it down to show us how it works.
Now, once a gun is used in a crime, finding where it came from isn't a simple task. Let's take a closer look at the ATF's process. Basically, they have to follow the gun from the time it's made to the time it's sold. The ATF sends the gun's make, model, and serial number to its tracing center. That's in West Virginia. From there, the center contacts the gun's manufacturer to find the wholesaler who bought it. And the wholesaler then provides the name of the dealer or store. Gun stores are required by law to maintain transaction and sales records, but tracing can get really tricky if the original buyer sells the gun to someone else or if it's stolen. There also is gun tracking right here at the local level through IMPD's Crime Gun Intelligence Center. Once investigators recover a gun, they fire bullets into a tank and the projectile reveals the gun's DNA. That then is entered into the National Integrated Ballistic Information Network, or NIBIN. The ATF can use this to see if unique markings from that particular gun match ballistics from other crimes all across the country. And here in Indiana, police departments are teaming up. They're sharing that data to track guns locally and across city and county lines.